Hello, welcome to this YouTube tutorial video. In this video, we're going to be talking about a particular type of cable. You'll often see it in domestic installations, commercial installations, and perhaps in office areas of industrial installations. And that cable is what you will commonly hear referred to by Sparks as twin and earth. But of course, that is the vernacular term for it, if you like. What we're going to be referring to it here by its proper name. Now, its proper name, as we refer to it in the college, I'm sure there'll be lots of Sparks watching this will be cracking up when I say this. We refer to this as PVC, PVC, thermoplastic, twin and CPC cable. Now, that's quite a mouthful, and when you go into the wholesalers, there's no way you're going to be asking for that. When you go into a wholesalers, you ask for twin and earth, and you know what you're going to get. But let's break down that big long name that we just spoke about by having a little look at the structure of this cable. So let's have a look at the structure of this cable. Now, we just gave that big long name to this cable, which was PVC, PVC, thermoplastic, twin and CPC cable. So let's break that down, because that big long name actually helps us to understand a lot about the structure of the cable. So we've got, first of all, PVC. Now, that refers to this part of the cable. This part of the cable is what we call the sheath. Now, it's important to understand that this sheath is offering mechanical protection. This layer does not act as an insulating layer, except incidentally. Its primary function is there to act as mechanical protection. And it's made out of PVC, which we know stands for polyvinyl chloride. So that's the first part of our name, PVC. Now, you see from the structure of this cable, you can see it's flat in its shape, in the way that it's laid out. The reason for that is that this cable is actually designed to be buried inside walls. It's designed to go underneath plasterboard or to be put on a wall, have a layer of capping over it, and then have plaster put over the top of it. And really, this layer, all it does is provide mechanical protection against the plasterer's trowel. You can see PVC is a very soft material. I can almost scratch it and dent it with my nail there. So it's not going to withstand someone trying to drill it or put a screw through it or something like that. It's just there to offer protection against a plasterer's trowel. So you would never install this in an area where there's a high risk of mechanical damage. So that's the first part of our name, PVC. We then have a second PVC, and that refers to this layer here. This is referring to the actual insulation that covers the copper conductor of this cable. So that's what we mean by PVC, PVC. So this layer here and this layer here are covered in a layer of PVC insulation, and that is there to insulate the copper conductor to stop the electricity from jumping out and leaking to places that we don't want it to go to. You'll notice the center core has no insulation over it. The reason for that is that this cable is never in good circumstances should never carry any current, and therefore doesn't require insulation. And if it ever does carry current, we'll cover in a later video, you'll see that actually it only carries current for a very short while. But when this is terminated, we don't like to leave just that bare copper sticking out there. So it's common practice to use some green and yellow sleeving, or earth sleeving it's referred to, cut to the right length, and that just pops over at the end of that conductor and covers it up, apart from the end part where you would terminate it. So we've got PVC, PVC, and then the next part of the name is thermoplastic. Thermoplastic, so what does that refer to? Well, a thermoplastic is a group of plastic type materials, of which PVC is one. And that family of materials behave in a very specific way. Thermoplastics retain their malleability when they get warm, when they heat up, and they can be remolded. There is another family of plastics called thermosetting, and we do use that on a particular type of cable, particularly on armoured cable, but we'll cover that in another video. So this layer of insulation, this PVC thermoplastic layer, has a very specific operating temperature, which is 70 degrees C. If you open up your regs book or your on-site guide, you'll see 70 degrees C splashed all over the book. And that's very important for the following reason. We know that when electricity flows through a conductor, one of the three effects that it has is that it starts to heat up the conductor. The conductor will start to get hot. Therefore, this layer of insulation has to be able to deal with that heat without breaking down. So that means that this layer of insulation, which is 70 degrees C thermoplastic PVC, can get up to 70 degrees C before it will start to break down, before it will start to melt and potentially break down and allow electricity to jump to places that we don't want it to go to. We then move on to the part where we talk about this being twin and CPC. Now you may be looking at this cable and thinking, but Joe, there's three conductors there. I can see three conductors. We only actually count the insulated conductors, if you like. So you can see here that we've got one insulated conductor, two insulated conductors. So that's where our twin comes from. And then we've got CPC, which is this conductor in the middle. Again, you'll often hear this referred to as earth. This is not an earth cable, an earth conductor. This is technically a CPC. But again, the difference between those will be covered in another video. So that's where we get the name from for this cable. It is PVC, PVC, thermoplastic, twin, and CPC cable. So Gary, that covers the construction of this type of cable, the PVC, PVC, twin, and CPC. Where's this going to fit in with our study program here at the college?
Extensively for the first 10 weeks of all the study programs we're going to be doing at the college, we'll be using PVC, PVC, thermoplastic, twin and CPC cables. Mm-hmm. And most of those circuits to start with are going to be lighting circuits. So we'll go through one-way, two-way and intermediate switching using this style of cables.
Good stuff. Well, in that case, we hope this video
has been some help.